What's up, guys? Our next guest, an old friend of the show. Good man, 10 years in the NFL, 3 years more than John. It's a sour subject for John. John's lifelong goal was 10, and you've achieved that. This would be like me. No, this is like me meeting Kevin James.
That's
it's that kind of bitterness. But Antonio Garay, what's up, buddy?
How you doing, man? Always a pleasure.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure. So how you doing, brother? Everything good?
I'm doing good.
You know? Now, someone told me you're a huge fan of the Fast and Furious movies. Of course, like the insane tragedy news.
I was having a big talk about it on the 29th, the day before everything happened. Because there was a big dispute between me and my older cousins about how it worked out chronologically with all the movies.
Right.
Because the guy Han, the Asian guy, died in Tokyo Drift, and then he died at the end of 6.
Okay.
So we got a big debate about it. Wow. So the next day.
There's 6 of them?
They're working on 7 right now.
Wow.
See, I don't understand how they can make 6 of them until you just told me you were discussing that with your whole family.
Yeah, you know? It was a very intense.
People love that.
I didn't know that.
Well, can they make it without
fast
Paul?
Fast cars and even faster women, you know?
I know. It makes sense.
How can you not like Fast and Furious?
It's a guy thing.
It's appealing.
But Paul Walker, can they make it without him? Now, this poor guy, Paul Walker, died only 40 years old, coincidentally enough, in a bad car accident. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it's mind-blowing. And he was doing it for charity, too.
Right.
The whole thing, right? It was for...
Was he racing?
I think they were just like, kind of taking people... This is what I heard. I don't know. I didn't read up on it.
Test drive for charity for the Philippines.
Oh,
I believe,
wow.
If I'm correct.
Yeah.
So it's kind of heartbreaking.
It's terrible.
But, 40 years old.
Of course, you know, the people on my Twitter could not be more mean or less creative. Do you know the joke? They go, "Are you guys here that Paul Walker had dandruff?" I'm like, "What?" Yeah, his head and shoulders went through the window. That was the joke. I mean, that could be made about any car accident. It's not even specific to Paul Walker. One of the worst death jokes I've ever heard.
That was a popular one.
But I retweeted it.
The Challenger. Chris.
The Challenger. McCullough. Those jokes were terrible.
Yeah.
Head and shoulders
washed up on the beach. That was a fifth grade joke for me.
Well, I was in like I was 19. I'm
really?
The one who started that joke. Yeah. What was the name of the woman who died?
Christina McAuliffe. Yeah.
Where did Christina McAuliffe vacation?
Krista McAuliffe.
Yeah.
Krista McAuliffe, where did she vacation? All over Florida.
That was awful. We watched my fifth grade class.
Sorry,
we were watching that launch live.
Well, it's a good one. And plus, that's time. 30 years has gone by. But Paul Walker, it's a little sore for the head and shoulders. Especially how terrible of a joke it is. It's like terrible.
Yeah, it's definitely. But I think I was even talking about it tonight. How you going to fit? I think it was just more than halfway done.
Right.
And they had like 2 more places to shoot.
Wait a minute. So they were in the middle of shooting a movie.
I didn't know that.
Because
I guess they were saying like, I'm getting all this for my female cousins now because, you know.
Don't try to say that. Like you had Paul
Walker.
Saying
like, no, it's been a big deal though. Like, I guess Tyrese been all broken up about it. And
well, I do get worried about what Tyrese is upset about.
That's what I heard. I heard you're a huge Tyrese fan.
Who's Tyrese? Now, I'm thinking of Tyson Beckford. I'm thinking of the 2 different guys.
They all look alike.
Hey, he said that, not me.
No, yeah.
You mean all models?
Yeah.
Right.
Both models.
Yeah. All models do look alike.
Yeah.
What are you going to say?
Only on the Art of Elang show, let me tell you.
Oh, thanks. You can blame it on me. I bring out all my racist material with the Art of Elang show.
All of it.
You're like one of those guys who projects something on you.
Last time we had the same talk.
We did? I don't remember.
We had the same talk last time because of all the linebackers at camp. They all picked on you, the big black guys.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
pimp something.
That's how.
Oh, the pimp daddies.
The pimp daddies.
That's how John's racism started. You're like one of those guys who project something on you. Like, oh, do you love this joke? 2 Jews walk into a bar. Like, what? Now do you think they could, like, they might have to kill him off in the movie then? They were like, how do you explain?
I don't know if that's politically correct, though, right?
Well, he's dead in real life. Politically, you're going to bring up political correctness now? Mister, they all look alike. All of a sudden, you're Jesse Jackson over here.
It happens.
Hey, listen, linebackers can get away with it.
Hitting the head too many times, concussions. Uh-huh.
Now, how do you feel about that? Now, John is clearly going for the fake lawsuit.
He's got the special seat thing going on.
No, I mean, I do worry, you know, I mean, what are you thinking about that? Do you feel any sort of discomfort or abnormality in your memory?
Impairment?
Yeah.
I mean, unfortunately for me, I think when I talk to all the other guys that I know that's been in the league,
yeah,
it's really like 3, 5, 6 years after where they really start noticing any type of the effects.
Okay.
Once you're not working out at that same type of level,
right,
training, lifting, running, and all that, and then all of a sudden,
I think age,
you start
has
to feel that
a lot to
the
do
impairments.
With
it. You don't
well,
really
I think,
notice it.
I think, too, when you're playing, and we were talking about this before the show, when you're playing, you got a lot of stuff coursing through your system. You know, for instance, I would take a Toradol shot every game.
I didn't realize this.
I would get IV'd up, Toradol shot. I was taking Indocin, Vioxx, or Diclofenac every day.
They would
day.
Give you an IV?
Taking, yeah.
What, that's of Diclofenac?
Taking opiates, you know, as well.
I love
that. When I could get them.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of pretty much part of the game. I think it's starting to change a lot now.
Yeah. I would think people can't get away with that, man.
Yeah, they're not masking the injury. Yeah. It's amazing when you watch, you know, the review of the NFL weekend, how many guys go out of the game with a concussion.
Yeah.
That never happened. 10 years ago, no one went out of the game with a concussion.
But there's just, I mean, just the nature of the game, sports in general, things have changed so much between the knowledge of concussions and how you got to keep guys out now and the tests that they got to go about just to get back into the game.
Yeah.
To even using the term bullying nowadays is kind of a sore subject.
Oh, well, I know.
There's so much stuff that has changed that even technology with Twitter, Instagram.
It's just a way to get in trouble, man.
Yeah.
You know, if you have a couple of drinks and you start tweeting immediately, you know, forget about it before you know.
I mean, you had guys that have done that plenty of times, you know, not just even telling them where they're at,
right,
being in the wrong spots, whether they're in a gentleman's club.
Or a Klan meeting.
Possibly. I haven't heard of professional athletes do that just yet.
Well, they might have. They almost do. Some with the N-word they throw around a lot. You with everyone looks alike. My God, you're going to get me kicked off the air. But Diclofenac is a great rapper name, though.
Mm-hmm.
MC Diclofenac.
Yeah,
it is.
Did you take all that, like John is telling you? Were you IV'd up before a game?
For the most part, IV. I've only been IV with, like, just the...
We would do like preemptive IV.
Before
the game started, we would get IV.
I would do it sometimes, do it at halftime if I felt.
Really?
I think, but sometimes even in sports though, it's kind of if you do something and it worked, you kind of want to do it all the time.
Of course, yeah.
So you don't even know. Sometimes even if you feel good, you know you always took a Toradol shot before the game, so you take it this week too.
What exactly is Toradol? Is it a painkiller?
It's just a
masking agent.
A massive anti-inflammatory and painkiller. I mean, they use it for
like
surgeries.
It's like taking like 100 like Tylenols.
Yeah,
but
it's also an inflammatory.
If you get hurt, you don't realize you're hurt, so you can play right through it and make the injury worse. Technically, right?
Technically,
because you can't feel it.
Well, I can tell you,
But I mean, this year you're seeing a lot of guys that aren't making it through a whole season like they have in the past.
Yeah,
they're not being
as aggressive with the preventative.
Because a lot of
older
doctors believe that they're going to do whatever it takes to help the athletes stay on the field.
Get out on the field. And the question you always asked was, if I play, will I make it worse? And I was never told that I would make it worse ever. That's the question I would always ask.
If I play, will I make it worse?
Yeah, and they always said, no, you'll be fine. It's fine. Now, you don't even ask that question, right? If I play, will I make it worse? It is, well, we need to get you better before you get back on the field.
Now, was there peer pressure?
It's a different take on it.
Was there peer pressure? Would they call you like a pansy if you would say no?
It was understood.
Really?
There was no. If you spent time in the training room, you were kind of marked as soft.
Really?
You know, if you were in the training room more often than not, guys were looking at you with the angry looks, giving you the evil eye.
And what
eye.
Would they do? How would that manifest itself? Would they, like, let Richie Incognito, take a dump in your locker or something?
Sure.
What do you think of the Richie?
Sure. There was all kinds of stuff.
Sure, that sounds great.
Take a dump in a shoebox and put it in the Foot Locker.
Yep. You've done that? You took a dump in a shoebox?
I didn't take the dump.
And put it in an African-American player's locker?
No. I've seen dumps taken in shoeboxes and shoeboxes put in the Foot Locker.
Oh, so you were that guy.
You've seen it.
I can't believe it.
You've seen it.
It wasn't my poo.
How dare you?
So you actually got someone else's poo put
no,
in the box.
No, I saw it. I saw.
And
I was
that's your book. It wasn't my poo by John Ritchie.
I saw a lot of stuff.
We got to take a break. When we get back, I want to ask your opinion on the incognito thing, how you would have handled that, and talk more football, more. Listen, it wasn't my poo by John Richard. Look for that at Barnes & Noble coming up.
The Artie Lang Show, weeknights on Audience, only on DirecTV.